Alright everyone, welcome to part 2 of my gargantuan fighting game collection. And to finish off Saturn stuff, we have World Heroes Perfect, the last in the World Heroes games. Good version, but get it on PS2. It was in North America. You'll see it later in this video. We also have X-Men Children of the Atom, the first of the quote-unquote Versus series, though this wasn't really Versus anyone, but it was still one of those Marvel fighting games, style fighting games, and it's definitely the worst aging of them all, for sure, because it just, they really tweaked it much better, obviously, in later incarnations, but this is still an alright game. And lastly, X-Men vs. Street Fighter, which of course was the second one in the series, and if I'm not mistaken. And the first of the actual versus anybody else thing, and so it's actually pretty good. It still is pretty good today. And now some Super Nintendo, Super Famicom stuff. We have Power Instinct. Alright. Teenage Mutant Turtles Tournament Fighters, which is pretty legitimately pretty damn good. Skip the other versions, they're not even the same, quite the same game. Actually different, the NES and Genesis versions, and they're shit by comparison, so just stick with the Super NES version. We have Gundam Wing Endless Duel, pretty damn awesome. I'm not even a Gundam guy at all. Like, I just don't care about Gundam, but it's a great fighting game. So I assume that the Gundam fans, or at least Gundam Wing fans, or whatever, will get more fun out of it than even me, maybe. Fatal Fury Special. Definitely the best old school Fatal Fury game, no question about it. Well, get this on PS2, just one sec. I mean, PS2, Super Nintendo version's good, decent, pretty good, but, you know, the music's jacked up, though, in the Super Nintendo version. And Killer Instinct, pretty solid game. I know the wannabe fighting game lovers love it more than me, but hey, to each their own, I suppose. And now to my all my PlayStation 3 stuff I did not get to already. We have Blade Blue Continuum Shift. I don't know what to say, it's just so good. So fucking good, just go get it, that's all I gotta say. Just go get it. That way you can be ready for Continuum Shift 2, because this is the version that they'll be adding on to play Continuum Shift 2, so just go get it. Motherfuckers, just go get it. King of Fighters 12, a solid game, obviously nothing nearly as good as previous iterations, which we'll be getting to those, because PS2 is jacked up with King of Fighters, in my opinion, or at least for me it is. So, I liked it, but it wasn't quite as good of a game as in past iterations. I'm still looking forward to King of Fighters 13, hopefully that'll come out. Maybe. On consoles, maybe. Yes, I have a box for the download Marvel's Capcom 2. I like my boxes, what can I say? So anyway, yeah, you already know about this. You're going to see it again on my PS2 stuff. It's pretty good, so I hear. Though not as good as the next one. And that's the follow-up. Marvel's Capcom 3 Special Edition. I love this one. It's easily my favorite of all the Marvel style fighting games that Capcom made. Yep. I like it. I like it a lot. And we have Tekken 6. Shiny covers. For the win, I guess, right? Shiny. Yeah, it's Tekken. It's pretty similar to Tekken 5, obviously, and it's actually really good. Really good. Of course, we have Super Street Fighter 4, the follow-up to the other one, pretty good. Adds tons of fucking characters. So, that's cool. I like that. Definitely worth a pickup. Then we have, lastly on PS3, Virtua Fighter 5. Virtua Fighter was never a series for me that I really got much into until PS2's 4, even though I was there since the beginning, in arcades in 93, playing the first one a little bit, but didn't really click with me until the fourth one. But that's those. Get those out of the way. And now, to cap it off, we have a crap ton of PS2 fighting games. Get this first stack near me. And we start off with ADK Tamashii. It's one of the many SNK Neo Geo compilations, one of which, like this one, didn't come to the North America or Europe or whatever. And the reason it's in my fighting game collection is because of one game, and that is Ninja Masters, which is this middle one here. And, well, actually, no, it's, I forgot, Gangan's on here too, which is also right here, which is also a fighting game. Aggressors of Dark Combat, that's what this is also known as in the West. So, yeah, it's not very good, but Ninja Masters is totally good, though. It's pretty good. Pretty good. And, of course, it's got Twinkle Star sprites and other things on it that are pretty awesome. So, there you go. Here we have Arcana Heart, the first one. This is the Japanese release. I remember the U.S. version got, like, some kind of, like, slight, like, omissions in, like, some of the introductory sequences before the fights for some reason. I don't really know why. So, anyway. This includes both the original Arcana Heart and the updated Arcana Heart Full. So, very good, very, very good fighting games. Just happen to have all girls in it. I haven't played the second one, which is also on PS2. And the third one, of course, is on PS3, which I'm still waiting to get, as I said earlier in the previous part of this video series. Next up we have more SNK Neo Geo stuff, Art of Fighting Anthology. Includes Art of Fighting 1, 2, and 3. Not a particularly good compilation here. 3 is the best one for sure. 2's okay, 1's average, so basically, unless you care about King of Art of Fighting, don't bother. That's pretty much it. If you don't know what Art of Fighting is, then you already don't care, so trust me. Our next one is another Neo Geo thing. Didn't come to the North America or the West or anything. This is a really good one, too. It only has 2 games in it, but it's really good. And this is Bakumatsu Roman Gekka no Kenshi 1-2, which to the West is known as Last Blade 1 and Last Blade 2. So a lot of people know how good those are, so yeah. If you have a way to play Japanese PlayStation 2 games, you must get this if you like those games, because you're not going to get it unless you have a Neo Geo otherwise. So yeah, excellent. Highly recommended. Next up we have the rest of the Bloody Roar series that I actually can get on systems I own, or that I care to own them on. That's 3 and 4 on the PlayStation 2. Solid games, nothing stellar here. I mean, if you've played any of the PS1s, you know kind of what to expect, and that's pretty much what they are, so. And we have more Capcom Classics collections because they have fighting games on them. This first one obviously has the first 3 Street Fighter 2s yet again. So it's another time I have them. Street Fighter 2, Champ Edition, and Turbo. And then, of course, we have Volume 2, which has the one actually worth getting for, which is Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo. I would say, you know, since this is the only, it's one of the few for, I can't think, is Super Turbo, is that like on any other console? Like, besides the 3DO, which nobody cares about. I don't think it is, so there you go. And then now we have Capcom Fighting Evolution, known as Capcom Fighting Jam outside of North America. Maybe this is the title in Europe too, I don't know, but either way, it takes, you know, various different fighting games in Capcom's Street Fighter Alpha, Street Fighter 2, Street Fighter 3, Darkstalkers, and Red Earth, and puts those characters together. Includes all of this, their systems as well, their super bars that differ. It's kind of a big mess, in my opinion. So, yeah. It's okay. Next one's much better than okay. It's actually awesome. It's Capcom vs. Escape 2. Yeah. This is a crossover done right. And it includes all of the, you know, different variations on the different games in SNK and Capcom's series of, you know, different super meters and mechanics and whatnot. But it does it in a smart way instead of, you know, the stupid way that Capcom Fighting Evolution does it in. So yeah, definitely a great game. If you're interested in anything like this, it's amazing. We have DOA 2 Hardcore. Dead Alive games never been particularly great to me. Mostly button mashing affairs. They just are way too imprecise when you try to do shit. It just feels like everything just strings together and you don't know where the brakes are, so you don't know what to press. It's like, yeah. It's alright. I've played DOA 1 and on PS1 of the day. I don't own it, obviously, but because you've seen my stuff for that system. But, yeah, you know, that's how I feel. I played DOA 4 as well. Still gives me the same feeling. We have some random purchase I made one time. This is Eremitar Gerard, I think it's called. It's based on some anime, I think. I don't know anything about it. I just know it's not very good. That's all I know. It's a 3D fighter. It mostly sucks. Next. Fatal Fury Battlecrafts Volume 1. So, obviously this came to North America, and it is worth getting, if for nothing else, because of Fatal Fury Special. Because the others, not really worth it. Fatal Fury 1, pretty ass now. Fatal Fury 2, it's a lot like Fatal Fury Special, except it has less stuff. And they don't have any real legit combos in them, for some reason. But Fatal Fury Special added, you know, the kind of things that make that possible, so it's better. By default. And then Fatal Fury 3 was just very average. It just took Fatal Fury Special and said, hey, why do we have that when we can have something shitty? So I don't know. So basically, if you want Fatal Fury Special, that's what this should just say on the front. Fatal Fury Special. Because it's totally still worth playing. I love it. I still think it's great. So get it for that. Don't get it for the rest of it. And then we have Fatal Fury Battle Archives Volume 2. This one's a little better compilation than the last one. Has the Real Bout series, Real Bout Fatal Fury, Real Bout Fatal Fury Special, and Real Bout 2, the newcomers. Yeah, they're all pretty damn good. The two best ones, the last two. The first one's pretty decent. So yeah, pick it up if you're interested. It's pretty solid. Here's another one that did not come west. Who knows what direction, right? It's Foon Super Combo. This has two. It only has two games on it from the Neo Geo. The first one is known as Savage Rain in the West. The second one is Kazuna Super Tag Battle, one of the most rare games on the AES Neo Geo system. So yeah, they're solid games. They're okay. I like the Kazuna Super Tag Battle better than Savage Rain. So yeah, not required, but if you're a big Neo Geo guy or SNK fan, whatever, yeah, maybe you might want it. I did. You can tell. But if you want the best Fatal Fury experience, here's the one to get. This did not come to the U.S. on PlayStation 2, unfortunately. It did on Xbox, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe I'm wrong about that. I know it did on Dreamcast. And it's Gyro Mark of the Wolves. It's also on 360, if I'm not mistaken, as a download. So yeah, this version is, at least I know about this version, it's pretty much arcade perfect, and it's amazing. So, really great game. I liken it to Street Fighter 3 in the sense that most of the original cast in like the old Fighter 3 games was replaced by new people, and it actually worked, and you know, it was a lot better. At least I think it was. So, Gyro Mark of the Wolves. Awesome game. We have some Guilty Gears here. We have Guilty Gear X2, and then a much later version of the series. In fact, well, pretty much the last one that they did of the Guilty Gear series so far is Guilty Gear XS Accent Core. US versions, that's obviously what this is. This is the Japanese version of Accent Core. There's obviously Accent Core Plus, which came after Accent Core, and I guess that's the one you want, I suppose. I mean, I know that was also in the West. It's on Wii, it's on PS2. Maybe somewhere else, who the hell knows. Obviously, Arc System Works, really great games. I don't like them as much as Blade Blue, personally, but I think they're a little too opaque, a little too hard to get into, but I think Blade Blue has just enough, you know, accessibility that it makes them better. Plus, they're still really good. But anyway. Last of this stack, before I move on to the next one, is the Hokuto no Ken Arc System Works fighting game on the PlayStation 2. Excellent game. If you're... You know, you don't need to be a Hokuto no Ken fan of the anime or manga to like this game. It's, if you like fighting games and like Arc System Works fighting games, then you'll definitely like this stuff. So it's very technical, very impressive. The only thing I would bitch about in this game is that really just that it has 10 characters total. Like literally, that's the whole roster, 10 characters. I can think of tons more from the anime that they could have added. So, but what do I know, right? Getting my next stack. Ugh, man. This Neo Geo stuff just doesn't end, I tell ya. here comes a big King of Fighters rush here. Alright, this is King of Fighters Orochi. This is a Japanese version, not the shitty American one that included... I think the American one included 94, 95, 96, 97, and 98. This one now includes 95, 96, and 97, but it's way better. It doesn't have the stupid sound glitches and fucking shitty load times. It's so much better. So, if you want the definitive collection of this type of thing, the Japanese version, you have to get those instead. Just have to. I played the ones that came to North America. There was that one Orochi collection for North America. It was god-awful, buggy shit. I could not believe that they could do that. Especially since they already made this beforehand. Like, what the hell are they doing? I don't know. Fuck them. Anyway. King of Fighters 90 Ultimate Match. Amazing. Like, I have the other one as well. You'll see what I mean in a second. yeah. Wow. This is a great update to one of the best King of Fighters games already, 98. But Ultimate Match just adds more characters and stages and mechanics. Just, yeah, it's really good. And and if you're a purist and you really want 98, the original 98 Neo Geo version, it's on here too, which is great. And it's not a fucked up, glitchy version, which is great. So, there you go. Pick it up. This is the North American release. It's like $10 to $15 tops. Amazing. You must get now. And here's the other follow-up to that last compilation. This is the King of Fighters NES. It includes 99, 2000, and 2001. Not only the original Neo Geo versions, but also includes the Dreamcast versions of all three games, which are also really good. So it's like, yeah, this one kicks ass too. The only drawback to this compilation for me is just the fact of what they are. Is that 99, 2000, 2001, the NES saga, whatever you want to call it, of the storyline, The games themselves, just I don't think are as strong as the ones that came before it, but that's just me. So, and yeah, that compilation never came here, at least not like as a NES collection or whatever. So, probably for the better, because they would have glitched that shit too, probably. Who knows? This one was quite. This one's quite older. This one came here, as you can see. It's a. They took the separate Japanese releases of King of Fighters 2002 and 2003, and they just slapped them in here and called it a double pack for North America, which is great because they're actually fantastic. Both are very good games. 2002 especially is really good. So, and these don't have problems. So excellent. You should pick that up if you like them. Next one is King of Fighters 2002. A limited match, specifically the Togeki version, as you can see, what that kanji says, Togeki, or as Westerners usually know better, as Super Battle Opera, that tournament in Japan. This was a slightly tweaked version of the original release on PS2. This is just like 98 Ultimate Match, except it's for 2002. It didn't get released in North America, unfortunately, because it's really fucking awesome, too. And it also includes, I believe, the original 2002 on Neo Geo with no problems. So, definitely worth getting. It's probably one of my favorite of all time on the series, so totally worth it if you have a Japanese PlayStation 2 access. Okay. King vs. Neo Wave was on Xbox in North America. Did not come to PS2 in North America, but this is the Japanese version, and it's basically tweaked to 2002, essentially. So, because of that, it kind of takes away. Even though it's a fairly good game, it's not as good as it could be, because it just seems like it was kind of rushed. Next we have King of Fighters 11, which is awesome. It's amazing. It's much better than 12. It has an active real-time tag system instead of the, you know, just having a team that just, you know, every round they switch out. I prefer the every round they switch out thing. I'm not a huge fan of King of Fighters adopting, you know, real-time tag personally, but it was done so well here. I can't really bitch too much. So, excellent game. Came out in North America. It's like $10. Pick it up, please. Come on. I paid $60 for this when it came out. Granted, it was like years before it came to North America, but come on, $10, so you could spare $10. King of Fighters 2006, it's the follow-up to Maximum Impact 1. Much better game, in my opinion, so if you... I like this one. It's pretty damn good. So, I don't have to say. It's Maximum Impact 2, but for North America. So, I think it's pretty damn awesome. Better, much better than the first one, as if I didn't say that already or something. We've already seen this before, so Marvel's Capcom 2, also on PS2, I have that. Alright, damn, I'm getting low on time. I don't think I'm going to even finish this. Jesus. Anyway, I have so many. Melty Blood Academia. English is my first language, maybe. I don't know. Melty Blood Academia, yeah. I liked Melty Blood and Melty Blood React on PC, so I got this one because I wanted the console version so I could play it better. But ultimately, I don't like the series that much, you know? They're okay. I like them, they're decent. That's why I don't have Actress Again, which is the one after this one that's also on PS2. So, that's that. Midway Arcade Treasures 2. It's on here because it has Mortal Kombat 2 and 3. So that's that. Mortal Kombat Armageddon Premium Edition. Not only for Armageddon itself, but because it also includes... The Premium Edition includes a port of Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. So that's mainly why I got this, because Armageddon... Well, I would say about Mortal Kombat in general for the most part, but whatever. So, yeah. But the Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3 port on this Premium Edition, which is only on PS2, by the way, isn't particularly great. So just wait for the PS3 360 download collection of the old Mortal Kombat's coming this year, because hopefully that'll be a lot better. Shaolin Monks. I know it's a beat 'em up, it's not a fighting game, but this game actually includes Mortal Kombat 2, so that's why it's in my collection here. Here we have Nam Collection. And this is five PS2 games, or I'm sorry, PS1 games on a PS2 disc from Namco. I mainly bought this for Klonoa, because it was cheaper, I think. But here it's on here because Tekken 1 is included, so there you go, that's why. Tekken 1 on PS2, yeah, I know. It's amazing, right? Naruto Ultimate Hero 3, or Ultimate Ninja 3 in the West, as you probably know it as. This is the probably one of the first PS2 imports I ever owned. They're okay. Like, I like Naruto, but this, it's pretty shallow, I think. So anyway, it's that. More SNK stuff. Neo Geo Battle Coliseum came to North America, so it's like $10 or something. Yeah, it's a very good fighting game with some original unique characters, the crossover with a lot of the Neo Geo characters from different games. It's pretty interesting. Looks like I'm going to have to go to another video here. The Rumblefish. I wish they had Rumblefish 2 on Neo Geo PS2, but they don't. This is the only one. Rumblefish 2 didn't get console release, but this is really good. I like this one a lot. It's actually pretty solid. Well, I'll go to another part, so we'll have a part 3. It's going to be much shorter than these, though, these other two. I'll see you then.